Are you ready to boost your confidence when selling so you're able to close more deals? Nikki Roush will show you how to build a foundation of skills and a mindset that creates sales success without feeling pushy or salesy and without fear of rejection. She is a sales strategist and coach with more than 25 years of sales experience and is master certified in neuro-linguistic programming. This is a radically different approach to selling. It's a no sleaze, no slime, and no stress approach to building your business. This is Sales Maven. Here's Nikki.
Welcome, and thank you for listening to the Sales Maven Show. I'm your host, Nikki Roush, your own personal sales maven, here to offer you tips, techniques, and strategies to master that sales conversation. In today's episode, we are going to be talking about how to communicate in a way that drives sales. Now, before I do that, I want to give a few shout outs to people who have taken the time to leave a really wonderful review. I want to share that just completely touches my heart. It's like the most tender place in my heart when somebody has something nice to say and when they're enjoying something that I do and finding value in the work that I do. So thank you to all of you who have taken the time to leave a review. I want to read just a couple of them because they're so fun to read, I will say. I try not to check every day because then you get that like that expectation like, oh, nobody liked me today. But I will say every single time I find a new one, I'm like completely tickled by it. So here is one from Elizabeth Cook Communications. Thank you, Elizabeth. I actually know Elizabeth. She is amazing. And she writes, so much value. Whenever Nikki shares, no matter the platform, she teaches something valuable. Her expertise and genuine care exudes every interaction. I always walk away with an actionable tip that I can implement immediately. And I already feel more comfortable in the selling process. That is awesome. Thank you for that. I am committed to trying to give as many actionable tips as I can possibly give in the platform of this podcast, because I know that if you go out and implement this and get results, your confidence is going to grow in the selling process, and you will have a bigger impact in the world, which in turn will make a much better world for all of us. So that's the goal. And then here's another one that came in, which I have to say, I'm totally tickled by this one too. The title was My Business Therapist on the Go, which I will say totally tickles me. All right. It says, while Nikki provides incredibly easy to implement sales strategies to grow your business, she also balances that with the no-nonsense mindset work that we all need. And she's always got a good story to solidify her teaching points too. Every time I listen to an episode, I don't just walk away with a sales tip to implement related to my business. I walk away feeling like I just got off the phone with a wonderful therapist who has given me permission to set boundaries, own my expertise, and to stand in my beliefs around who I am as a business owner. Now, it doesn't say who wrote this. The review says it was written by Great Info. So I want to thank whoever took the time. And again, totally tickled by this. I love that you feel like you and I are just in a phone conversation as you're listening to the podcast. As the podcast, I will say, as an avid podcast listener, I can so relate to that. I often talk back to the podcast when I'm listening, and I feel like the host and I are in a conversation. So you've made my day with this review. So thank you so much. Okay, so let's get on to the show. And again, we're talking about how to communicate in a way that drives sales. So you might not be surprised to learn I'm going to share with you some counter things that people are doing that's actually costing them sales. And then, of course, we'll close out with some ideas, some things for you to be thinking about, for you to go and implement into your business right off the bat. So a lot of this episode is going to revolve around what I call the go fish mentality. And I briefly brought this up on a podcast that I was interviewed on recently. And the podcast is the Brainy Business Podcast with Melina Palmer. I was so excited to be a guest on her podcast. It was episode 96. I feel like you probably already listened to Melina, but in case you don't listen to the Brainy Business Podcast yet, I would encourage you to go listen to it. It is one of my all-time favorite podcasts. So I was again, totally delighted when I got to come on her podcast and talk about the things that were causing people to not take action. And so on there, her and I had this great discussion and I brought up this go fish mentality. And when I'm deciding what content I'm going to put into my own podcast, and whenever I write an article, all of these things, they usually happen as a result of things going on in my life or things that clients are experiencing. And so that's what actually prompted this particular topic today. A good friend, actually one of my closest friends, reached out to me the other day and she was sharing some frustration. I think she was also looking for permission. You know how sometimes we want other people in our lives to give us permission to not hire somebody. And this was the catalyst for this conversation. She said, you know, I've had this text exchange with somebody that I've been trying to hire. And every time I ask this person a question or multiple questions, they give me really vague responses. And I'm super frustrated by it. And I was like, well, let's talk about it because maybe they're not understanding your question. Or, you know, I'm also checking to see like how, like who else could you hire instead? And are there other options out there? Or is this really the person you want to hire? And when it came down to it, she was asking, I think the two questions that really pushed her over the edge, there were other things involved, but the two questions she sent to the person was, where do you meet? Because this is something where she would have to physically go to and have a meeting. So where do you meet? And what days of the week do you meet? And what time? And the person responded back and said, oh, we meet at these two locations. And that was it. And then she's like, okay, but what about the rest of the information? Like, what am I supposed to do with that? And this is where I come in and I talk about this go fish mentality. When clients ask you questions, they want answers to their questions. And this idea of being really vague in your response or just answering one of three questions or one of two questions, it can really turn people off. And ultimately, she decided, which is something I always advise, vote with your wallet. Don't give your money to people who you feel like are not going to be responsive to you or who aren't going to take care of you and also who lack attention to detail. As a salesperson, your job is to make it super easy for this person to take the next step with you and ultimately pay you money. And when you give these really vague responses, it's this go fish mentality. Now, I've written articles about this. I actually have an article that I wrote. I think it's actually called, what is this article called? I feel like I have it somewhere. It's this idea of, are you making it easy for people to do business with you? And I think I actually call it a go fish mentality. I'll have to look it up. I'll put it in the show notes for you, this article that I wrote. But I remember, and this happens all the time. Okay, I'm going to give you a little disclaimer here before I go on with the story. Because oftentimes when I tell these stories, it brings into your awareness the things that are going on kind of in our culture and the way that we communicate with each other. And it's often like I had a friend who used to always say, it's a blessing and a curse, because once you know it, you can't unknow it. So here's my disclaimer. What I'm about to share with you, if you have not noticed this pattern before, this may actually drive you a little batty once you are aware of it, because you're going to hear it and experience it quite often. So an example that I've shared, I don't think I've ever shared it on the podcast, but I've shared it multiple times when I train because I talk about this go fish mentality, is calling to make an appointment to get my teeth cleaned with my dentist. And I see this a lot when I'm calling to get a hair appointment, when I'm calling to make a doctor's appointment. Frankly, it happens a lot just when you're calling to make an appointment. So I call my dentist, you know, the front desk person answers the phone and I explain like I'd like to get, you know, an appointment to have my teeth cleaned. And she says, great. When would you like to come in? And I go, well, Thursday at 3. Oh, I'm sorry, is her response. The hygienist isn't available Thursday. She's actually not working that day. Is there another day you'd like to come in? So I'm get my calendar. I'm looking at my calendar. I'm like, the following Tuesday at 10. Oh, I'm sorry. Our staff is out that week for a training. Is there another time you'd like to come in? And now, like, the hair on the back of my neck is starting to stand up because I just want to scream, could you please make it easy for me to get this appointment? Because I'm going to come in, and yes, I want something and I'm getting something from you, but I'm here to pay you money. You should make it easy for me. Like, instead of asking people, like, when would you like to come in? And not that you couldn't ask the question, but instead say, you know, the next available appointment is 2 weeks out on this day at this time. Does that time work for you, or would you prefer something else? But don't play this go fish mentality. And when I talk about the go fish, I'm talking about that game. I don't know if you played that when you were little. We used to play it where, you know, you have your cards and the person guesses and says, do you have any queens? And then you say, go fish. And then you have to pull something out of the pile. So that's what I'm talking about when I say the go fish mentality. Do not make your clients play a go fish game when they are trying to pay you money. Because what's going to happen is they're going to lose interest, or they're going to become frustrated, and then you miss out on earning their business, which of course is not the objective here. The objective here is to actually gain the business and close the sale. So be really careful around this. And it's like I said, it's a very common pattern. I just had it happen to me a couple of weeks ago. Somebody reached out to me and said, Nikki, would you be interested in being interviewed for this upcoming thing that I'm doing? And can I talk to you next week? Actually, this happened twice to me in the last 2 weeks. And my answer was yes. So I try to make it easy for them, right, to get on my calendar. So I respond back and I say, yes, in this particular one case, I said, I'm available on Wednesday at 3:00. And then the person responds back and says, oh, sorry, I'm actually doing the interviews on Tuesday and Thursday. Would either of those days work for you? So I look at my schedule and I look how I can rearrange something. And I say, I can be available Thursday at 10. And then the person comes back and says, oh, sorry, I'm actually doing this later in the day on Thursday. And then they finally gave me the time. Now, this is a real go fish back and forth, because if the person had just reached out initially and said, Nikki, would you be interested in being, you know, interviewed for something? And these are recorded on Tuesdays and Thursdays at this time of day. Do you have time in your schedule next week for that? That is a much simpler conversation. Because every time you do this, like, back and forth, it's kind of like a tennis match, this, like, you know, I lob something to you and then you lob it back to me, like the ball, right? Like, we just hit it. Somebody's going to drop the ball. And in this particular case, we didn't, because I did want to do this and I was interested in doing it, but it shouldn't be so difficult. It shouldn't be so hard. And it doesn't need to be hard if you take the time to spell it out for somebody. So think about the way that you are communicating with your clients right now. Are you having them play this go fish with you? Are you answering their questions? And when you're asking them to do something or take a next step with you, are you being really clear in your communication? Specificity is one of those things that I find to be a real struggle in our kind of speech pattern nowadays. Too many people are too vague. And if you want to get the next, like, get the client booked, if you want to close that sale, the more specific that you can be, the easier you make it for the client to know what to do next. So when you want to earn somebody's business and you're sending a message, take a look at that message and go, did I answer all their questions? You know, is it super easy for them to see the questions that I'm asking back? Like, have I, you know, laid this out in a really clear form? Or is there some information missing? Now, oftentimes the reason the information is missing is because you know what you know. Like, you know in your head what the answer to this is, or why you need this answered, or when you're going to meet and all of those things. But if you're not including that in your communication, you are making it really difficult for people to take the next step with you. So this is the, like, take a step back, review your information, review what's going on, and then ask yourself, what am I missing here? Another story that I had recently with a client who followed up with me, and she was a little bit upset because she had somebody who had given her quite a bit of interest. Frankly, it was like, you couldn't have gotten a bigger buying signal. If you haven't heard my episode on buying signals, go back and take a listen to it, because it's super important to recognize buying signals. So she's like, you know, gosh, this woman, she was giving me these huge buying signals. She was reaching out to me, private message. And I don't know why, but she just kept like coming back and not really like doing the thing that I was asking her to do. And now she's just totally stopped responding. She's just ghosting me. And I don't know where I went wrong. And so when I looked over the message, like, what was really clear to me was that this particular prospect was asking a very specific question, and my client kept ignoring the question, not answering it, and instead asking another question back. And frankly, she didn't need the answer to that question that she was asking in order to answer the question the prospect was asking. And if you are demonstrating to your clients that you are not able to answer their questions, or that you're being vague in some way, and you're having this like go fish mentality and asking them to kind of continue to have to try hard, they just won't. And that's what happened here, is the client just stopped, or the prospect in this case, she just stopped responding. And I ended up giving my client some suggestions on how to go back and rewrite the message and to answer her question, and then see if she could resurrect this deal, which she did. And the client, like, her client now is a paying client. She's super happy, but it would have never gotten there had she not reached out to me and had somebody look over this. So that's one of my tips for you. If you feel like there's a breakdown in your communication with a prospect or with a client, and you're not really sure where it's gone wrong, it might be in your best interest to have somebody look it over for you, because we all have blind spots. I have them, you have them, we all have blind spots. And sometimes the blind spots are because we know what we mean, we know what's going on in our heads, and yet it's not being communicated properly to the other person. So in order to communicate in a way that's going to drive sales, you've got to be specific. You have to take the time to answer questions, and you have to take the time to make it super easy for your client to respond. I think I might even talked about this in Making a Powerful First Impression. I think it was episode or part two. I'd have to go back and listen to the episodes now, but I feel like I talked about that sometimes if you're getting frustrated that people aren't responding, like maybe you're asking a prospect or a client three questions in an email and their response is like, thanks or yes. And you're going, wait, what's the thanks for? What's the yes for? There's three questions there. Chances are you're not making it really easy for them to pick out all of these questions. They're all bunched together. So this is where I'm suggesting have somebody take a look at it, and without maybe giving them too much information, ask them like, what's the overarching message here? Or what are the questions that I'm asking this client, and see if they can say. And if they can't, you need to be more clear. And it's your responsibility always to earn somebody's business. So make sure that you are taking time, slow down, reread what you're writing, and see how you can offer some clarity to a situation. Because again, if you are struggling to earn somebody's business, it's on you to figure it out or decide, like, maybe it's just not a good client for you, which is fine. But if there's somebody you really want to earn their business and you can't get to that next step with them, it's usually because your messaging is too vague. And I know Melina and I talked about this on the podcast episode. We were talking about people saying like, let me know when you're available. Like, that's the most vague thing you could ever say to somebody. And it really does not get you what you want from a client. So making sure that you're making it easy to get on their calendar by offering them the three times. If you haven't heard me talk about the three times language, it's something that I teach. I feel like almost weekly. And it's something that when I'm rewriting my clients' emails, I put into their emails this three times language. Like, it's my job to give a client, if I'm trying to earn somebody's business, potential times for us to meet. It's not their job to tell me when they're available, because most of us are never available unless we make it easy to get on someone's calendar. So again, how to communicate in a way that drives sales: be specific. Let go of all this vague language, this let me know, this like, yes. Yes is not a good enough answer oftentimes to a question. It needs to say, yes, I can do this for you, and here's how to get it done, right? Like, be specific. Take the time to share a little bit more information to make it easy for the client to know what they're supposed to do next. And oftentimes what they're supposed to do next is pay you money. Get registered, sign up, right? Buy the product, whatever that piece is, but make it super easy for them. Don't ask them to jump through all the hoops, because frankly, they just won't. All right, so that was the topic of today's conversation. I hope this was helpful for you. And again, the suggestion that I am going to leave you with today is, if you have somebody that you are struggling to move through the selling process, there's probably a breakdown in your communication in some way. You need to be more specific. You need to be more clear in your communication. And the clearer you are, the more specific you are, the easier you make it for somebody to take the next step with you. So go back, reread the things that you've been writing, reread that conversation that you had over text with somebody that you felt like, this didn't really go that well. And see, what is my part in this? What could I say or do differently? And hopefully you're going to take a next step and touch base with that person again. See if you can do better and if you can earn their business now. All right. If you would like some additional resources, please go and visit. I have a special page set up for my listeners. You can go visit yoursalesmaven.com/maven, and you can register to receive all the resources that I have there for you. One of the things that's up there are the 17 buying signals. So you can download that list. Of course, you can go buy my book and read the book. It's got more detail to it. But if you just want to know, because I mentioned buying signals today, what those are, go get that resource and start paying attention to these buying signals. You've got to be aware of them. You've got to act on them. So that resource is there for you. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you for those of you who are taking the time to share this podcast with the people in your life who you know would benefit from it. Again, that's just, there's no greater compliment than having somebody reach out to me and say, oh, I heard about your podcast from my friend so-and-so. They suggested I listen to it, and I've already been able to implement something I learned. So thank you so much for that. Wishing you continued success. Take care.
Thanks for listening to Sales Maven. Visit us online at yoursalesmaven.com/maven for more resources to boost your confidence and skills.